So let me preface this data real fast before we get into the manipulation. I collected this data using a syringe and a pressure sensor. The syringe is just a standard hollow 60cc syringe. There was a small 2-inch section of tubing connecting it to a absolute pressure sensor. And I measured the change in volume as I squeezed the plunger on the syringe and the pressure increase. So I'm going to go ahead and plot absolute pressure versus volume. And anybody familiar with the ideal gas law knows that pressure is inversely proportional to volume, or Boyle's law, I should say. Pressure is inversely proportional to volume. So P is proportional to 1, or K over V. What is K in our instance? Well, the ideal gas law says that PV equals NRT. If we manipulate it, we can say that P is equal to NRT over V. So if we fit this data using an inverse curve fit form, we can determine our coefficient value, which should be equal to NRT. Then we can take that data and determine the moles of the gas in the syringe. But before we do that, we need to get a curve fit that works. And let me show you how this works and doesn't work. First, I'm going to show you how this doesn't work. If we go, that sounds funny. If we go in here and we turn our inverse fit on, right, you'll see here that the model for this is exactly what we're looking for, A over X plus B, right? It doesn't fit the data right. It goes well outside the scope of the data points. There's a huge error. Something's not right. Can anybody tell me what's not right here? If you may have noticed when I was describing the setup, we were changing the volume of the syringe, but there was a 2-inch section of tubing that connects the syringe to the sensor. The volume of air that's in that tubing is unaccounted for in this data. There's two things we can do here. The simplest is to simply take our data and subtract that offset value that wasn't accounted for. Or we can account for it in our curve fit. And to do that, we're going to use a user-defined fit. Our user-defined fit is going to look just like the fit that we were using just a second ago, except this time I'm going to include an offset here in our expression. Does everybody see what I did? If I hit accept, we can go back here to our data. And you'll see here that the fit, I'm going to turn this inverse fit off. Oops, I don't want to turn the power fit on. You'll see that the fit goes right through the data points. So what coefficient is of interest in this equation? The A. The A is of interest in this equation, right? We want that A value to determine the moles of gas that are in the syringe. So now we can take that coefficient value, go back over here to our manipulation, and we can show that the number of moles of gas is equal to the coefficient value divided by R and T, right? The temperature, room temperature. And if we know that that we can compare what our experimental value is to a theoretical value, if we know that at room temperature there's 44.6 moles of gas per cubic meter, and we had 2 × 10⁵ cubic meters in our syringe, we can compare our theoretical to our experimental, and you'll see that the values are quite similar. Again, another application, coefficient values from the curve fit used in the mathematical representations.